health insurance. Do you have it? I've been fortunate. I've had health insurance my entire life. It's never lapsed. But I'm one of the lucky few. I and my family have been able to afford it. In spite of that, 100% of my debt that is not related to loans for medical school is healthcare related. It involves costs of co-pays and deductibles that I just don't have the money to afford. For many years, I have known that this country needs health reform. We are a country that, in spite of having some of the best hospitals in the world, we're only number 37 on the list. Most of the countries above us on the WHO, that's World Health Organization's list, have nationalized health programs. Well, so do we. It's called Medicare and Medicaid. But those aren't enough. There's still millions upon millions of people who are uninsured, who don't have any coverage at all. And it's because they don't qualify for Medicare or Medicaid, and they can't afford coverage. As you all know, I'm a medical student. But I've also been a patient facing catastrophic illness. And as such, I know the value of being insured and of being covered. When I was sick, I was receiving treatments every 2 months that were $10,000 a dose. Without health insurance, I might not have gotten those treatments. I might not have survived. I had daily treatments that were several hundred dollars a dose. Again, without those, I probably wouldn't be here today. And without insurance, there's no way I could afford them. There's no way my family could really cover the bill without going absolutely broke. In the United States today, over 60% of bankruptcies are due to healthcare costs. That is unacceptable. 60%, that's way too high. I mean, the reality is a nationalized program overall would save money. It would keep people from delaying getting treatment. And when things are caught earlier, the costs are lower and the outcome is far better. With preventative medicine, it's even better still. And the truth of the matter is, when these people don't get regular checkups and wait to get care, it costs us more, because we end up paying for it anyway once they go on disability. And we could avoid them getting that bad. People who are healthy are more productive. They can work. They can live their lives. And they can basically contribute to the economy. So the reality is, a national healthcare program and a public option will actually save our country money in the long run. Moreover, I feel that healthcare is a right, not a privilege that should just be for those who can afford it. I was extremely fortunate in that my family could afford it. I got sick 3 weeks before my 25th birthday. When I turned 25, my dependent coverage as a college student ran out. That was it. I had to go on COBRA. And for anybody who's been on COBRA, it's extremely expensive, the monthly payments. It's outrageous. As I said, I was extremely fortunate that I have a family who could actually afford to cover those costs, as well as the additional costs. Most people aren't that fortunate. And I am extremely grateful that I was born into such a family, because if I wasn't, as I said, I'd be dead. I am the standard deviation of a very bad statistic. With the form of the kidney disease I had, at the time, I was the only person the NIH had ever seen recover from that particular form of it. Statistically, I should have been an end-stage renal failure or dead 5 years ago. But today I'm healthy. And it's because I had that coverage. It was because my doctors were willing to go the extra mile for me. I'm a medical student. I am preparing to take my board exams right now. Just a few weeks ago, I was in, just last month, I was in Pennsylvania for a review seminar. Thanks, Violet Kitty. She put me up for the 5 days, and that was really sweet of her, and I'm grateful. We had a good time, too. I'll show you a picture of my class at the seminar at the end of this. But I took the NBME, National Board of Medical Examiners test, and I needed a 328 for my school to certify me to take the USMLE, United States Medical Licensing exam. I got a 440, so I'm happy. But anyway, back to what's important. I am asking you to write your congressmen, your senators, and your representatives. Write to Kathleen Sebelius. I'll give you the email address over there in the description. I guess it's that way. And I'll also give you a petition link for healthcare reform. Guys, everybody, whether we like it or not, our lives are interconnected. I mean, YouTube is a good example how we're all interconnected. But the truth is, had I died, I would not be a productive citizen today, contributing to the economy by working. I would not be a medical student, pursuing my education, pursuing my degree, and pursuing my desire to help others. If I were not alive, I wouldn't have been there to rescue a drowning victim in Samoa, a man who is now a grandfather, who is a volunteer for the Japanese International Cooperation Agency, their version of the Peace Corps. He went back to help more people in Samoa. Currently, he's in Argentina helping more people. And as you can see, all our lives, they touch other lives. We're all interconnected, and by taking care of our brethren, we're taking care of ourselves too. Please do what you can to promote this health reform and to bring about a public option. We need it, and ultimately it's good for you. If you're ever out of work, if you ever can't afford insurance, it's good to have an option. These stupid ideas of death panels, you know, end-of-life counseling was being offered as an option if you wanted it only. It wasn't being forced on you. And you know, if I had been terminal, I would want end-of-life counseling for my sake and for the sake of my family. These arguments against it are completely ridiculous. And it's time that we took a stand to do what's right. So check the links out and do what you can to make a difference. Make a difference in my life. Make a difference in the lives of those around you. Make a difference in your lives. Thanks.